Hey everyone, and welcome back to Gal. I recently finished watching the new HBO miniseries called Chernobyl, which reenacts the horrific nuclear accident that sent radiation soaring through Ukraine and Western Europe. It was absolutely devastating, but the show was extremely well done and I highly recommend watching it. One thing I loved about the aesthetic choice was how they visualized the radiation in the show. While radiation in reality is completely invisible, we cannot see it. The filmmakers wanted to show how the civilians and firefighters didn't see it at all, but they wanted us, the viewer, to see it to create suspense. So they chose to use a particle dust effect on the footage. Now, I've seen a similar particle dust effect on Stranger Things, the show on Netflix, as people in the show entered the upside down world. So since I saw this again, I was like, I really want to see how I can replicate this effect in Premiere. So I went onto VideoHive, which is a part of Envato Market, and there I searched for dust and particles, and I stumbled upon this pack called Cinepunch. The pack not only had the dust particles that I needed for this effect, but it also had over 9,000 other elements, such as transitions, color presets, sound effects, fog effects, horror titles, and so much more. Now, my first thought was, there's no way that I need all of this for this project, but I realized that the price was only $49, and a lot of this pack could come in handy for other cinematic looks that I'm trying to create in the future. So I reached out to the author of Cinepunch and asked if they would be interested in sponsoring this video, and gratefully, they did so. So thank you, Cinepunch team, for making this tutorial possible. And one last thing the author of the pack wanted me to reiterate is that you only need to buy this pack once and you can use it forever in unlimited project. So let's go ahead and go into Premiere Pro and I'll show you how I built this Chernobyl look-alike scene using color presets, dust effects, and horror sound effects, all from the Cinepunch pack. So here I have a firefighter clip that I got from Envato Elements to make a similar scene and color as this clip that I took from the actual series Chernobyl. So the first step is to match the color of this clip using the LUT master, which is a part of the Cinepunch. So the LUT master is actually a bunch of presets that you can import into your effects panel. So if you go to effects and you go to presets, you can right click on this folder and import presets. So inside of Cinepunch, you can go to the installers folder and then just choose the Premiere Pro version folder that you use. I use 2019 and above, so I'm going to select the LUT master and then hit open up. And once it's done importing, you can select presets and then you will see the LUT master. And inside, you can then see all the hundreds of amazing different stocks and different looks that this pack includes. Now, I found that the horror styles actually worked really great to replicate this scene. So you'll notice over here in the Chernobyl scene, it kind of has kind of like a mustardy green tone. So over here on the left of each preset, you can kind of get a color palette of what it looks like. Now, Dangerous Love Horror kind of has some sort of grayish green undertones. So to apply this to this particular clip, just double click to apply it and immediately you see the change. Now I think it looks pretty close. There are a few adjustments that we may need to make. So to do that, just select the clip and we're going to go up to Lumetric Color here. If you do not have Lumetric Color open, you can go to Window and just make sure that Lumetric Color is selected. So here what you can do is you can now see that the Dangerous Love Horror preset is applied, and if you hit the effects, you can toggle on and off. Now underneath Creative, you can also use this intensity slider to reduce the effect or increase the effect. I'm going to increase it so it's a little bit more dark and olivey, and then from the curves, I'm just going to brighten it up a bit so there's a bit more color. And I'll go back to Creative just to add a bit more vibrancy so it looks good. And I think this is great. Now I chose to apply this to the clip level, but of course you can always use adjustment layers and apply effects to that adjustment layer if you have multiple clips that you're working with. So then the next effect I wanted to create was the particles themselves. Now if I go back to project, I've downloaded and imported inside of Cinepunch in their big pack section all of the cine dust effects. And the effect that I chose was the subtle atmospheric particles one. So I'm going to drag and drop that on top of this clip, and immediately you'll see the particles here, but there's no video clip. And this is because we have to use blend mode. So we're going to go up to effect controls, and from blend mode, we're going to change this to screen to remove all of the black from this. So now we just see the particles, and it looks pretty much like the radiation that was depicted in the actual miniseries. And if you need to, you can always reduce the opacity a bit. So if you hit 80, it makes it a little bit more subtle. If you toggle down, you can actually use the slider to reduce or increase the particles until you achieve the opacity that looks more blended in with the scene. So I think that looks pretty good. So we have the particles, we have the color effect. The next thing I'm going to do is just roll this in so it meets this clip. And now on to sound. Cinepunch comes with a bunch of great sound effects. And if I go down here into sound effects, I've imported some ambient, some frequency, and some haunted clang sounds. So the first thing I'm going to do is just drag and drop the eerie ambience 5 down here. And I'm going to cut it off here. And I'm going to add in some haunting clangs. Drag and drop that in here, and then just cut it off here as well. And I'm going to add in some frequency, like some radiation. So let's see which one sounds good. I think the frequency one sounds good, so I'm just going to drag and drop that here, and it'll kind of come in at the end. So what I'll do is I'll add an exponential fade here, so that will just kind of fade in over time, so it's not immediate. And then what we can do is we can kind of play it back just to see how it sounds if we need to lower the levels at all. All right, it sounds super creepy. And what I want to do is just fade everything out. So I'm just going to select and hold shift the two clips here, apply default transitions, and then I will also copy this exponential fade by hitting Command C and selecting these last three clips, and then Command V to paste. And so now that the fades are there, let's go ahead and play back the final effect. So thanks again for watching this tutorial, and I encourage you all to check out Cinepunch. It's seriously the Swiss Army knife of effects for any type of look that you're trying to create. And also go watch Chernobyl on HBO. It's seriously amazing. Thanks again for watching, you guys. If you guys have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!